These are 10 more shortcuts that you've requested, and we're getting into hard mode. Get an alert while you're by the grocery store, but only if there's items on your list. Get directions to multiple locations, and then start directions to whichever's fastest. Turn on focus modes when you have something scheduled on your calendar. Send photos directly to an album based on your location. And we go all the way to expert level, building an entire pilot logbook from one shortcut. Links to all these shortcuts are down in the description. Use the chapters to jump to a shortcut that interests you. And this might be the first time you've ever seen one of my shortcut videos, but trust me, you're gonna wanna subscribe. All right, to start out, we're just gonna warm up with a quick automation. Someone asked, can I automatically enable or disable always on display based on time? Well, we're gonna go to the automations tab here in shortcuts, hit the plus button, and we're gonna have to create two of these, but we're gonna go with time of day. To make it easy, we'll just choose sunrise every day. This is going to happen every day, and we want this to run immediately. That step is important, so you never have to confirm or click yes. We're going to do new blank automation, and this is a one-step shortcut. Just search for always on display. You'll see that as an action here, and we can turn always on display on at sunrise every day. That's the entire automation. We'll hit done, and if we wanted to, we can create a second automation. This will also be time of day. Let's do sunset. This will be weekly, run immediately, hit next, and we're gonna do the same process, adding a single action, set always on display, and this time we'll choose off. Now, if you have a 14 or 15 Pro, always on display will enable every day at sunrise and disable every day at sunset. All right, number two, we're gonna use OCR to get text from, let's say, a piece of paper and automatically create an Apple Note. This is my daughter's birthday list. She took the time to print it out, which is cool, but I want this in my phone as a note. So here I've created a shortcut. We start with the action, take one photo from the back camera. If I expand this action, you'll see this toggle show camera preview. You wanna toggle that on. If this is off, it's gonna take a picture without ever showing you like the preview window. So keep that toggled on. We're gonna add this action, extract text from photo, and then we're simply going to create a note with the text from that image, and then we're gonna add it to one of our note folders. I've chosen shortcuts here, and I'm gonna have the note open as soon as it runs. That's the whole shortcut, so let's hit done. I'll put the list here. Now when I run the shortcut, it's going to open the camera. I'm simply gonna take a picture of the document. You can choose to retake, but I'm gonna use the photo. It's gonna use OCR to recognize that, create the note, and boom. I have a perfect note of everything that was on that document right here. You can add actions like copy this to clipboard, send it in an email, and this will work for handwritten notes as well, but depending on the handwriting, your mileage may vary. Next up, someone requested they wanna be able to take a photo, but upon taking it, if they're at their work location, it actually gets sent directly to a specific folder on their iPhone. This way they have all their work images in a single album in Photos, but everything else will be taken like normal. So what I've done here is actually created a shortcut. You would put your work address here in the top action. Next, we're gonna get distance from your current location, meaning the phone's location, to that address. So how far are you away from work? Then we're gonna have an if statement here, and we can actually adjust the if statement to choose if the distance from the previous action is greater than, and it's returning number of miles, if you're outside of the US, number of kilometers, and we could say is greater than 2 miles. So if I'm more than 2 miles away from my work location, I'm actually gonna do nothing. And I'm putting this in an automation, so it'll make sense in a moment. Otherwise, in the if statement, I wanna open the camera right here from the shortcut. Again, we wanna toggle on that show camera preview action, and then we can specifically choose to save that photo to an album. This is the save photo to specific album action, and you can pick any album on your iPhone. Now, the reason why I set it up like this is because we're actually gonna create an automation. I'm not gonna put it on camera, but I'm actually gonna put my home address here because that will act like we're at work. This shortcut that you download in the video description, just make sure to put your work address here. Now that we have that shortcut set up, I'm gonna go over to the automations tab. I'm gonna add a new automation, and this time we're gonna choose when an app is open. We want this to run immediately, don't notify when run, and the app, we're gonna choose camera. This way, whenever you open the camera, whether it's from the lock screen or swiping over, this automation will always run. Now let's hit next. We're gonna do new blank automation and simply search for the run shortcut action. Now we can choose our proximity photo. There's our photo by proximity shortcut. I'll expand this. Nope, nothing to do there, and hit done. Now, whenever I open the camera, it's gonna check, am I near work or not? If I'm within 2 miles of work, it's actually gonna go into the different camera mode and then add that photo directly to my wallpaper's album. So again, I changed the address to my current location, meaning work. Now when I open the camera, it's actually gonna run that shortcut in the background and we're gonna see the interface change. Now this is actually taking a photo directly from that shortcut. And if I take the photo, this time, this photo will be added directly to that album that I specified. Let's check that wallpaper's album. And sure enough, there's the picture I just took, and it went directly to that album. Now, I made it seem like I'm not at my work location, and now when I open the camera, nothing's gonna happen. I can just use my iPhone camera like normal. I'm not at work, so it's not gonna do anything different. Now, you have a couple options with this. You can add it to the home screen and just run the shortcut from there. Or instead of a nothing command here, you can choose to open the camera, and then when you run the shortcut, it'll check. If you're at work, it'll run the action that adds it directly to an album, or if you're far from work, then it'll just open the camera app like normal. All right, this next shortcut is to actually get traffic from multiple destinations, calculate which is the fastest, and then get directions to that location. So what I have here is I've added three street addresses. I've only put in city and state just for quickness, but you'll want to put the three location addresses here. You can do this with as many as you'd like, but after every street address, I'm getting driving directions from my current location to the address that I specified above. And then I'm setting a variable for each location. So here I have location one, here's location two, and then here's location three. Now I've added this text block just so we can see it when we run the shortcut, but this is gonna tell me the driving time to each location. If you don't even wanna see this, you can just X out the actions. Then next, we're gonna add an if statement. Now we have our first if statement. For this, I chose if travel time is shorter than or equal to 60 minutes for location one, I chose those variables. Once you tap in these if statements, you can choose which variable, and you'll see this is location one. Then I'm gonna open driving directions from my current location to location one, automatically. Now we have to add a second if statement. This commenter had some specifications where he wants to go to location three, but only if it's less than 90 minutes. So we have another if statement here saying, if the driving time is shorter than 90 minutes to location three, get directions there. Otherwise, get directions to location two. That might be a little confusing, but let's run it and it'll make a little more sense. So it's first gonna just tell us the driving time to all three locations. That might be enough for you. Then you can choose which location you're gonna go to. And as you can see, the shortest drive right now is actually location two. And so once I hit done, the rest of this shortcut is then gonna get directions from my current location to that specified location. Here it opens maps, and we now have directions to the location with the shortest commute time. All right, number five, someone asked if they can have focus mode automatically enable when there is something on their calendar, like an event. Now, there is that Siri suggestion that pops up on the lock screen sometimes, but that's a manual process. You have to actually click enable. This is kind of an imperfect method, but it might work for you. So I've started with getting one event from a specific calendar. Ideally, you'll have your school schedule or classes on a single calendar, and you'll want to choose that calendar here. Let's choose from events. Then for the second if statement, what I've done is if the start time for the next event is in the next 15 minutes, and we're going to use this in an automation, so I'll show you that in a second, then turn on Do Not Disturb. And one of the options in the Do Not Disturb action is you can say until the event ends. So we can actually have this automatically disable once that calendar event is over. But in order to automate this, we have limited options for triggering this shortcut to run. So let's go to the Automations tab. And unfortunately, there's no calendar event trigger or anything else. Maybe we'll get some new actions at DubDub this year, which is next week as I'm recording. I hope so. So basically what you would have to do is, depending on how many classes you have during the day, I would schedule a time of day trigger for this automation. Now this is imperfect and it's gonna be a little cumbersome setting it up, but once it's set up, you should be good to go. What I would do is actually set up an automation to run every hour that you might have classes running. So maybe this runs on the hour every hour, which would be an automation every hour. You'd have to create each one manually. But let's say every day at 7 a.m., we're gonna go ahead and run it daily because it's gonna be based on our calendar, so it shouldn't bother us on the weekends. We're gonna run immediately. Hit next, new blank automation. We're gonna choose our run shortcut action and we'll add the focus during class. That's all we have to do and hit done. Now at 7 a.m. every day, it's gonna see, is there an event on that class calendar? And if so, turn on the focus mode for the duration of the event. Now I would go through and add an automation like this for every hour of my school day. So 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, however long your school day is. Then it's just gonna automatically cycle every day. And if there's a calendar event, it'll set that focus mode. The setup is gonna be a little cumbersome. I wish there was an event trigger, but this was the best option I could come up with at the moment. All right, number six, someone asked if they could be alerted of groceries when they're near the grocery store, but only if there's something on the list and if only they're connected to CarPlay. This one gets a little more complicated. I'm using a Toolbox Pro action here at the top, which can actually get what audio device is currently connected to your iPhone. You'll need to know exactly what the name of your car is or how it shows up on your phone. I put Soul here because my Kia Soul, that's how it shows up as an audio device. So this shortcut is gonna run, it's gonna check what device is connected, and if it's connected to my car, Then the next action is get any reminders from my groceries list. And then if upcoming reminders has any value, meaning if there's anything on that list, show a notification and we can type whatever we want here. And I also put a vibrate device just for good measure if it's in our pocket or something. Now, if we want this to run whenever we're near the store, we're gonna go to the automations tab, hit the plus button, and we can choose arrive as the trigger. And for location, we're gonna choose the store. I'll choose a grocery store here, and you'll see the map at the bottom where you can adjust the proximity. So if you know you drive on that road there and that's when you wanna be reminded, just increase that proximity so it'll catch you as you're driving. Let's hit done. Now this automation is gonna run when we're near the store. This can be run anytime, or you can choose a specific range, like from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. We're gonna run immediately, hit next, and we're just gonna do new blank automation, you know the drill. We're gonna run our groceries by proximity shortcut, and then hit done. Now whenever we drive by the store, that shortcut's gonna run in the background, and it will alert me if there's anything on that groceries reminders list. All right, in my last shortcuts video, which I'll link above and down in the description, I did one powered by ChatGPT, which you can access in the share sheet. Whenever you're looking at a picture, or even if there's something on the web, it uses a Toolbox Pro action, that's a third-party app, again, link in the description, where I extract objects and text, runs it through ChatGPT, and summarizes it for us. I'll put a link to that shortcut from the share sheet in the description, but someone asked about doing it specifically for screenshots. So what I've created here is the first action gets the latest screenshot on your device. I've used the same two actions, Toolbox Pro, recognize objects, and then the extract text action, which is built into shortcuts, from that latest screenshot. I still run it through ChatGPT 4.0. It's gonna create a little summary of what's in it, show it to me, and then also speak it to me. I did that because if the person is visually impaired, you might wanna remove that quick look action and just keep the speak action, so it will tell you what's in the screenshot. For reference, here was the last screenshot I took. It was of my website. So let's just run this shortcut. We don't have to be looking at the screenshot, and let's see what it does. And here's the description that ChatGPT gave us. It also tells us how accurate it believes its description is, and then goes into the details. But you can remove this quick look action, and then it will just speak to you.
The image contains a website with an 87% accuracy recognition.
And there you go. All right, for this next shortcut, it has a lot of actions, but it does something pretty simple. This person has night shifts that are typically scheduled from 4:30 p.m. one day to 9 a.m. the next day. And they just want to be able to select the date on the calendar and then add that calendar event. But because it's an overnight shift, sometimes this gets a little complicated. So we've started with a specified date. It's going to be a date picker. And I've formatted this date and added this text block. This way you don't even have to specify the time. All you have to do is tap the date where this night shift will start. It's actually going to add 990 minutes to that time, which is the length of the night shift that they specified. You can change this to hours, but if you do that, you can't do like 0.5 hours. So that's why I did minutes, just cleaner that way. And for that end time, I actually set a variable. This way it makes it easier to create the event. And now I have this adding to my calendar. The event is titled night shift. And then for the start time, it's gonna be the text, which is the date that I chose at 4:30 p.m. And then the adjusted date, which is the end time of their shift. Again, you can adjust some of these numbers if you have a different night shift time. But when I run this shortcut, all I have to do is choose a date. So let's say Saturday. I don't even have to worry about the time. I've automated, so it'll automatically start at 4:30 p.m. And you can see it already created that event. Here it is in my calendar. And you can see it's running from Saturday, June 8th to Sunday, June 9th at those specific times. All right, number 9, an alarm from reminder. Someone wanted to check, are there high priority reminders? And if so, create an alarm with the time of that reminder due date. So here I have a find all reminders, and you can use this filter, priority is high. There's lots of filters you can choose from here, but they just wanted high priority reminders. I'm just getting the latest one, and you can limit it to a certain amount of reminders. I did just one reminder. I get the due date, which is a get details from reminders action, and then simply create an alarm, and the due date that you have that alarm or the alert set, that's going to be the time of the alarm. And we're gonna call it high priority reminder. Now, like the previous shortcut with focus modes for classrooms, this you would have to run automations kind of regularly, scheduled by time. There's no trigger an automation when you create a reminder or anything like that. But if we run this, it'll get whatever high priority reminders, the next one that I just added, and will automatically create an alarm on my phone called high priority. If I go over to the clock app, you'll see there's my high priority reminder at the time that I had set, and that was from the due date in the reminder. All right, number 10, and this is the expert level shortcut. This is an entire pilot logbook that runs with one shortcut. Now this person, which I assume is a pilot, wanted to be able to log things like departure and arrival times, the total time of the trip, and some other data like aircraft type. So what I have here is choosing from a menu. This way you can do everything with one shortcut, but you do have to choose departure or arrival. So let's say you're leaving on a trip, you tap departure, it's going to get your current location and log that using a third-party app called DataJar. I'll show you how that's set up in a moment. It's real easy, but we do need that in order to get things like the travel time between the departure and arrival. We're also going to format the current date. This way we get our leaving time, log that to DataJar, and we're also going to get the aircraft and registration and log that as well. So that all happens at departure. Then, when we arrive at our destination, we would have chosen arrival. So we're going to run the shortcut a second time, pick arrival. It's going to get that data from DataJar, calculate things like the total time of the trip between the start time and the stop time. It's going to ask a couple other things like single or multi-pilot, whether or not there's any remarks that they want to write manually, conditions of the flight. And then I'm going to show all of that in Quick Look. Now, you can swap this out to just create a note in Apple Notes or another note app, but we just want to see what it looks like. Now, I'm going to run this a little backwards. I want to show you the departure because I already ran this before and logged some data. So let's just say we arrived at our destination. I'm going to tap arrival. It'll ask me, what was the duty? I'll say single pilot. What was the condition? I don't even know what these letters mean, but let's choose one. Any remarks? I'll tap no. And when it hits done, this is going to tell me the start location. I chose city. I'll show you how you could change that in a moment. And so the start and stop time is the same, but you'll see the start time is when I ran the shortcut and chose departure. Now, this is the time when I ran arrival. I have the aircraft registration there that I logged when I left. Total time in hours. Now, we can change that number to be minutes or something else, but that's total time in hours. The other information that I logged in those menus, and then that's it. I've also put a title here, which uses the current date. So if you add this to an Apple Note using a last action, then the title of the note will be that. Now, a couple things we had to set up for this. One is DataJar. Again, this is a third-party app. I'll put a link to it down in the video description. I use this for a couple different things, but all I had to do was create a new list. So I added a new value. Key is whatever you want to type. I did pilot aircraft and pilot departure, and then I chose the list option. I created three different lists, and you'll see them here. Pilot time, pilot aircraft, pilot location. That's all I had to do in DataJar, nothing else. Then over in shortcuts, for the departure side of this shortcut, I logged things like the current location, which was the city, and set pilot location. So this is the set value action for DataJar. And when I expand this, I actually chose to overwrite the last data. This is important. Every time you run this shortcut for the departure side, it's going to overwrite the last data because ideally you should be saving to a note or you should have it elsewhere. So if you accidentally run departure when you mean arrival, I'm sorry, but it's going to overwrite whatever data you had there before. But this just keeps it cleaner and it's easier to set up. Now you can also choose things besides the city, like if you want latitude and longitude or any of this other data, you can choose to have that for the location of departure and arrival instead of just the city name. But I just chose city. You can also add a text block here and format things like city and state if you want multiple and then add that to DataJar. You can customize that if you like. And you'll see another data jar here. It's my pilot time. That's the pilot time list I created. And then again, the pilot aircraft. And so this whole shortcut, if you download data jar and this shortcut together, it will all work. You just have to create those lists with these specific names, pilot location, pilot time, and pilot aircraft. Create those in data jar and you'll be good to go. This was a really fun one to create. Love this suggestion. Overall, I just really have fun building these, especially when they're complicated and they're a bit of a challenge. Now, there are some that just don't have answers yet. A lot of you are asking for automations like when an app sends you a notification. There's no triggers for things like that just yet. Again, maybe we'll get actions at WWDC, and I'll cover it right here on the channel, which is another reason to subscribe and hit that like button. I'm going to be covering all the news like iOS 18, Apple's artificial intelligence, which is rumored to come out as well. So you don't want to miss any of that. But if you have shortcuts requests that I have not gotten to yet, leave comments below this video. I enjoy the challenges. I enjoy building these. And so I would love to keep trying to create more and more advanced shortcuts to help you with your work, your productivity, personal life, whatever it may be. If you want to see one of my past shortcut videos, like the ones where ChatGPT 4.0 powers all of them, I'll put one of those videos right up here. And if you just got one of the new M4 iPad Pros, I have my review. I'll link that down in the description. But I also reviewed the first and I think only magnetic charging stand for the new M4 iPad Pro. I'll put that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.